Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim, Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who...
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب زدني علما وارزقني فهما يا رب العالمين الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله is with the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has enabled us today to complete one more day in Ramadan, the day 12 of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, we have completed with the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever amal that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us to do, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it and put it in our mizan on the day of judgment, inshaAllah ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, Ramadan, as we said, is a month of good amal, deed, starting from the Quran, starting from charity, starting from i'tikaf, starting from tahajjud, taraweeh, zakat, Salatul Jama'ah, and all good deeds that we do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiplies them. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the first 10 of Ramadan is mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rahmah. And the middle 10 is maghfirah. And the last 10 is itqun min al-nar. So we are in the second 10. The second 10 of Ramadan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives a lot. So we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us regularly of our sins. Because our sins are so much, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His blessings can forgive. And we've looked into so many topics so far, into ikhlas, niyyah, Quran. There's so many topics that we've looked at. Today, inshallah ta'ala, our topic will be on hifdhul lisan, protecting and making sure that we take care of our tongue. This tongue, it can take you to Jannah, and the same tongue can take you to the hellfire. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, someone came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked him, "Oh, the Prophet of Allah, advise me." قَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهَ أُوصِنِي قَالَ عَلَيْكَ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. This person asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and told him, advise me, give me something, tell me something good to do. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, عَلَيْكَ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. I'm advising you to always fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wherever you are, remember that you are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fear Him. فَإِنَّهَا جِمَاعُ كُلُّ خَيْرٍ. Fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accumulates all the khairs, all the best good things is in fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It starts being accepted in fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued in his advice saying that wa alayka bi dhikri Allah ta'ala, and I am advising you to remember, to be in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your deed. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued saying that وَتِلَاوَةُ الْقُرْآنِ فَإِنَّهُ نُورٌ لَكَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَذِكْرٌ لَكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ. And reading the Quran regularly, because that Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and makes it nur for you on the earth, and وَذِكْرٌ لَكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions you in front of the angels. If you read the Quran, recite the Quran regularly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you nur. Because these are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entering your life, entering your heart. So if we beautify our heart with Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts nur. A person that has Quran and a person that does not have Quran, You can almost, by looking at them, you can almost tell. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued. He said, وَخْزَنْ لِسَانَكَ إِلَّا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَإِنَّكَ بِذَٰلِكَ تَغْلِبُ الشَّيْطَانِ. He said, make sure you keep tight of your tongue. Protect your tongue except from doing good deeds. Because by doing that, he said, you will win the shaitan. The shaitan wants you to just say things. Because with this tongue, as we will see inshallah ta'ala, you will gain so much things using this tongue. And with this tongue, so many people will go to the hellfire because of the tongue. So our topic today inshallah ta'ala is how to protect our tongue in gaining the pleasure and ridha Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ulama have said, احفظ لسانك وقل خيرا حتى تغنم. Protect your tongue. Protect your tongue and say good things until you win the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, أو اسكت حتى تسلم. Oh, if you don't have something good to say, keep quiet. Keep quiet that you'll be protected. Because the angels are here, everything that you say is written down. ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you would not say any single word. It doesn't matter whether it is good or it is bad. If it is good, the angel Raqib will write it down. If it is bad, Atid will note it down, and you will get punishment if it is bad. He says, therefore, this alim said, فَإِنَّ السَّلَامَةَ فِي السُّكُوتِ. In keeping quiet, you are protecting yourself. Because you will not be held into account in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for keeping quiet. You have not said something. So Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu anhu arda, and the Sahabas, Sayyidina Uthman used to take a piece of stone and put it in his mouth. A little piece of stone and put it in his mouth so that he does not just speak. If he wants to say something, he used to take it out, say it, and return it back. In the fear that it says something so that Allah becomes unhappy with him. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you would say one single word that will upset Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will throw you in the hellfire. 70 years you will not reach the bottom of it. 70 years. You will say something using this tongue that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be so upset with what you have said, he will throw you in the hellfire. For 70 years you will not reach the bottom of it. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من ملك لسانه ستر الله عليه عورته. If you control your tongue, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. If you start looking at other people's problems, what they're doing and this, and you start talking bad things about them, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not protect you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ما يستر. If you're looking at other people's problems, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring your problems in the open. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَمَنْ كَظِمَ غَيْظَهُ وَقَاهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَذَابَهُ. Whoever has the ability to control their tongue and their anger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect them from the hellfire. So if you have the ability to control your anger, because people, when they're angry, they lose control. If you lose control, you will not know what you're doing. And through this tongue, you will say things and you will say and say. Once you finish saying and everything, once you calm down, then you start regretting. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you are angry, go and do a wudu. Simple. When you are angry, go and run and do wudu. Because the anger, he said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, anger is from shaitan. And shaitan has been created from fire. And fire you put off with water. So when you are angry, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you are angry, run and do a quick wudu, and then inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take that anger from you. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَمَنْ كَظِمَ غَيْظَهُ وَقَاهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَذَابَهُ. Whoever Allah gives him the ability to control the anger, Allah will protect him from the hellfire. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued, وَمَنْ اَعْتَذَرَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ قَبِلَ اللَّهُ مَعْذِرَتَهُ. If you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness, if you say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I've made a mistake through my tongue, through my life. Huh? If you stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives.
Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman, don't give in to shaitan. Oh, you who believe, please give thanks to Allah. Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Rahim. Allah is the one who loves the Muhsinin. He is our creator, He is our sustainer, and He is the one who...